You know what? I feel like I almost called it. I knew this was not going to go down. I knew it wasn't going to be like, oh, M's just going to say what he's going to say and everybody's just quiet. I knew it was going to be some shrapnel. Nick Cannon, The Invitation. This is an Eminem diss with Suge Knight, Charlie Clips, Hitman Holla. I don't know. I feel like this is World War III right now. Here we go, yo. Dang.
Number will be monitored and recorded.
Check this out, Eminem, whatever your name is, right? You know, I don't ever do no talking, but Nick and family, this is your invitation, to prove to everybody else what you're about. What it takes on. Eminem for this.
Punish everywhere, now it's money on a bed. I could say I love it, but it's hard to understand. I just want the real, baby, you can have my last. You know if you go out, baby, ain't no coming back.
Ain't no coming back, that's a fact, it's the invitation. Told Joe to lean back, don't get hit with this retaliation. So I fuck with crack, but the white boy, he fuck with crack. Crack pills and...
You F with crack, but the white boy, he's effing crack. Stupid. I don't know. I hope you guys are gonna bring something more. Because this is not 2007 or 2008. This is for real. This is war. Okay? Come on. Freaking for real, man. Yikes.
Smack the shit. About to relapse. Call Kim. Somebody get Haley and that other kid.
Oh, now you done did it. Oh my God. Call Kim somebody. You guys were just all making fun saying that Em needs to quit bringing up Mariah. It's been 10 years ago. Nick, you were just on expeditiously T.I.'s podcast talking your talk. We're gonna do that right after this. We're gonna go and hear what Nick had to say. That's how this started. Wasn't because, oh, I'm just sitting there thinking about 10 years ago. 2 months ago, you're over there with T.I. Don't you know that Royce just made a video? Just dropped a song? Guess who's in it? T.I. Somebody get Haley. Oh, snippity snap. Figgity facts.
Call Kim, somebody get Haley and that other kid you raising that ain't even your baby. Took a
Daddy?
page out of Drake book, this might get a Grammy. We going back to back till you respond on the family. My baby mama killed you off a decade ago and you still crying about it, bitch. Nah, who really the hoe? I called Joe to set you up and you fell for the job. Slim won't show for the video cause he terrified of my squad. I heard your chauffeur got a video of you sucking the cop. You paid him off then laid him off, now who really the op? Should call me the new Pac, I ain't no killer but don't push me. How the fuck y'all?
You ain't no killer, but don't push me. Why are you stealing on Pac's lyrics right there? I don't like that. Saying a whole lot of stuff. Trying to say that, remember that big dude that went on all the talk shows? I don't know if he said that he really had a video of any such thing. That would be hard pressed to find, but I know that guy is not somebody that you'd want to believe. But the fact that he's saying all this.
I ain't no killer, but don't push me. How the fuck y'all got me battling Elvis Pussley, nigga?
Punish everywhere, now it's money on the bed. I could say I love it, but it's hard to understand.
Yeah.
I just want the real, baby. You can have my
incredible game.
last. You know if you guard, baby, you know how I'm
This gotta be karma, cause he shit out of luck. Eminem the perfect name, cause this nigga a nut. You used to beef with Nickelodeon, Nick. He called hit and I come with the mop and get on my custodian shit like bada boom, dotted beam. Lima scene got spaz, put Eminem in a bag, it's Halloween. This ain't an 8 mile battle, man, I'll do you awful. My competition in the target, I think it's Marshall.
power.
Come on. This is what you're bringing? This, oh my god. All due respect. You guys should have took your time. Took your time. You guys know he's heard every candy joke, every candy bar line. God dang. I can't even look at you guys right now because this is just... I feel like I can hear him laughing from Detroit right now. I feel that. Jeez. Yee. Oh.
Everywhere, now it's money on a bed. I could say I love it, but it's hard to understand.
Facts.
I just want the real, baby. You can have
incredible.
My ass. You know
I got
you
it.
Go, baby, you know coming back.
Come on, Nick, that's Marshall. You don't need help.
Nigga, you a rider.
No safety, fuck a seatbelt. What, is he out of his mind? I got a Glock, and don't Eminem belong on the side of a 9? That's crazy. Man, you act like Nick hurting your dreams. You an Eminem, how you mad at Starburst on the scene? Let me find out you still in that trailer park, this how we do. Run up and shoot the trailer. This the preview. Clips.
This is what, oh man, come on. You know what, honestly, if it wasn't Eminem, if it could have been anything else, it could have been anybody else, I'd still be like, this is what you came with? Trailer? A trailer double. Whew. Wow. Why are you guys trying to, like, make it seem like Eminem still lives over there at 8 Mile? Okay. I guess that's how you guys want him to feel, I guess. Oof. Enid getting people involved? If they want to involve themselves, okay. Everybody's going to get it then. All right, I see. Okay, okay, hey. You know what? The more the merrier. It's diss track season. Everybody's getting it. Everybody. Okay, let's go. Because this is... Wow. Came at him with some Starburst lines.
I could say I love it, but it's hard to understand. I just want the real, baby. You can have my last.
You know, I am. Nah. Ain't really for the culture. Fuck a baby mama in a choker. Pick up like a chauffeur. And then I to the wall like a poster. Four nymphs, she'll get cracked like cocaine mixed with soda. When I take a soul, if the bitch die, I'ma still eat her. I'm a vulture. Well, I'ma write your name in your mouth. You 47 chasing clout. Obsessed came out in 08, and you just putting something out? Damn. Cause Marshall think he an ape, but a white.
Wait a minute. I mean, I like that. I like that beat. That beat was fire. Finally, I was starting to get sleepy. Obsessed came out in 08. And The Warning came out right after that. We didn't hear nothing. But then, Fran over here with the turban. Shout out to Johnny Carson. Why did he have to go on T.I.'s podcast, though? Did everybody forget? I mean, dude's gonna go down the rabbit hole, right? You know, he has always said, just don't bring him up. Just don't bring him up. T.I. brought him up, then just say, look, I decline to speak on it. Just, I'm not doing it. Just say, I'm not doing it. He's always saying it. Because right after this, we're going to go on the podcast and see what happened. We're going to see what happened. This fool is not obsessed. Because you guys are talking about he's pushing 47 or whatnot. Mariah and Marshall are about the same age. Just saying. You want to call him Grandpa Marshall? So what do you call him, Mariah?
boy with a backpack. I do this shit for my real niggas, not the white boys trying to act black. On God.
Trying to play that race card, I love it, Nick. Trying to play that race card, I love it, Nick. You were trying to do that too on the podcast. You were trying to throw it out there, and T.I.'s like, I don't play that. I don't play that. You're trying to throw it out there. I don't play that. I like that. You got everybody all riled up. The white boy, the white boy, the white boy. Okay. Okay. Got bars when you say that, though. All right. Okay. That's how you want to play it. Okay. Let's see what everyone's saying. Nick Cannon fires back at Eminem for dissing his and Mariah Carey on Fat Joe's new song, Lord Above. Listen as Nick rounds up Charlie Clips, Hitman Hollis, Suge Knight, and Prince Easy for a rebuttal titled The Invitation. They're going to get ripped apart. Well, that's a fact. Wait, what is this? LMAO Nick boy, stop. You looking real stupid out here. Well, that ain't a lie. It's a no for me, dog. Facts. This fixing to be interesting. I don't know. First, okay. Hate Nick if you want, but he 100% right talking about Mariah left him 10 years ago, and he's coming up on 50, is still throwing shots at Mariah. Okay, but I want you to follow me over to that podcast, and that is why. Let's go.
Yeah, I love it, but it's hard to understand. I just want the real, baby. You can have my last. You know, if you go out, baby, you no coming back.
It's time to sit that old busted ass motherfucker. But you gotta realize, you run that shit out there, man. And at the end of the day, you got every person in the industry, and every person in the streets. See, where are you gonna go? He just new vanilla ice. It's just a matter of time. He hanging, right? Eminem's a bitch for bringing bullshit up that's not true. Say some shit, and then when shit get a little hot, everybody want to fall back. Or they want to run around with all these police. You know, the ain't part, you're going to be a rapper, anytime you're a rapper, you should have a whole bunch of police badges around you. Anytime you be a rapper, you're supposed to be able to meet up with motherfucker to handle your business. But all we got to do is get that motherfucker in the ring with you, and you're going to beat the dog shit out of him. That motherfucker's up. Nick Cannon is a foreskin itself. And if you
Did you say it's a foreskin? Shout out to Upchurch, man. Those words get around. I don't know who was talking for you, Nick, but I'm going to tell you right now. M even said in his lyrics, he's a unicorn in human form. You want to really get this fool in a ring? I like you, Nick. I liked you in Drumline. I don't know. There's probably some really good wild and outs. I think Channing Tatum was on there once. He did a great job. I think he was dealing with something and Beyonce came out. I think that was the only other one that I saw. That is not the move. Okay. My money, 100 out of 100. I am so tired. Yeah. It's going to be on M. There is no way. This fool's in tip-top shape, dude. Been trained. We don't even know what else he's been trained in. But, yeah. I'm going to go with them. Yeah. Ten steps, 20 steps ahead of what you already think you might be ahead of.
Probably was having a conversation. Y'all got the same energy of doing stuff for the people. You're not scared to do stuff for the people. So if this dude want a real target on his back, that's on him. But don't talk no shit and go in the hype. And you know what you call a man who ain't gonna stand up and fight? He's a bitch. We should tell the motherfuckers in Detroit he got 24 hours to respond. They need to kick his ass off that motherfucking city.
You have 60 seconds remaining.
Okay. I see your strategy. I like this. I see your strategy. Okay. All right. We'll see what M says. He's got 24 hours to respond. I bet in the last 24 minutes, if he listens to this, probably needs less than that to just write up a response. Wow. You guys really didn't come with nothing hard hitting though. Let's go over to the podcast so I can get some rest. Cause I know you guys aren't gonna hold on to that narrative. Here we go. Shout out to T.I. I'm trying to say from 10 years ago when you were on here September 19th. Come on, man. Nick Cannon's got beef with Eminem. When a man talks trash to your wife, you gotta step up. Watch Nick explain to T.I. how his fight with M all went down. Okay, though.
Whoa. I was like, whatever he wanna do, I'm with it.
God.
And this is the only reason why.
People may not remember this. But I do recall you having a battle of sorts with the likes of one of the greatest wordsmiths / rappers known to man in Eminem. Mm.
Yep. This is Mariah's fault, too.
You know, we're actually doing an episode on Expeditiously about some of the greatest hip-hop beefs of all time.
Facts.
I'm sure you know you won't make it on there, but for those kids,
I should, Tim. I should.
Hey, man.
He didn't want to battle me. It could have went down.
Can you blame him? I think it was 100,000. It was a boxing.
I was like, whatever he want to do, I'm with it.
God.
And this is the only reason why.
I wish I
could have hollered at you.
That Mariah pussy got
it. Was, nigga, think about it.
Biting, you
nigga,
hear me?
Nigga, think about it. You in a situation, right? Uh-huh. I think we was flying back on the jet from Africa somewhere.
Did you hear this shit?
And this motherfucker drop a song, like, talking shit, like calling her all kind of bitches and hoes.
Ooh.
I'm like, this is my wife. This is my new wife.
Ooh.
I got it. Like, and
it
I
was hard.
I wrote
that been hard.
Yeah, I wrote a letter first. I wrote a night. This was like, right.
Hey, that is not the move. I knew it. I remembered that. I remembered this. Dear M, you still not calling? Oh no, Nick. No. Yikes. Let's see what the comments say. Look at him. Look, he's like, what? You wrote a letter? Okay. You don't write a letter. Look at this. No, 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 no. That's funny. Nick versus M, who you got? Come on. I got 50, a.k.a. Curtis. M, Nick Cannon, the dude in school to talk the most S and then get his S smacked. Everybody knows it's gonna be M. Yep. See, I already knew. I don't even have to worry.
Right, I believe right when, I don't even know if Twitter had came out yet. Right during that time when social media just started popping. So I wrote this long-ass letter, pretty much saying, look, I respect you as an artist.
Right.
I'm actually a fan. I think you are one of the best to ever do it. But from man to man, you talking out of pocket to my wife, you got to be held accountable for that. So I need to see you face to face.
I can dig that.
And that's all I was saying. Face to face, let's get to it.
I can
now,
dig
and
that.
Whatever happens when we face to face, happy.
Well, I can do that.
You know
that.
What I mean? And it's funny because, you know, they like to build up these superhero characters.
They do.
But if you've ever seen Marshall Mathers in person, he's not someone that looked like he really wants to smoke with most.
I don't know.
I'm just
that
saying, for me.
I think he got that crazy white boy energy, though.
Yes,
I mean,
he does.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you never know what can happen.
You never know.
That's a fact. That's a fact. You could hear it in his voice. He is ready. He is ready for something to pop off. And if something is not going to pop off and he wants something to pop off, it will pop off. Look at T.I. T.I. is like, this fool wants to die. Look at his face. He's just like, this guy don't know. He never met him. Yeah, he don't know. Oh, my God. What? He lives in Detroit. Eminem has not left there. Oh my God, this is hilarious. Look at this. He's not even, he's just like, I'm gonna look this way. I'm gonna go look, what's over here? What's over here? What's over here that's so interesting? This is funny to me.
I'm just saying, I'm very secure with what, so I was ready for whatever.
Okay,
so I went looking for him.
Ooh.
I called managers.
Damn.
And at the time, you know, we was working, God rest his spirit, and Chris Lighty.
Okay.
You know what I mean? He was my guy. So,
right.
So, and you know, he had 50, and you know, him and Paul was cool. So I was like, look, if you want to get on the phone, if I need to come to Detroit, like, what is it?
Uh-huh.
Like, because you done disrespected my wife, and this is my, I gotta show my wife I'm a man, for
that's
one.
Real. Well, yeah, you gotta.
And then two, it got, you know, he said my name. I'm like, look, I know I ain't gonna be, I said that, I know I'm not gonna be able to out-rap you, but I will whoop your ass.
Ooh.
And those were the exact words.
No fumbles.
At the time.
Yeah, man. I mean,
cooler heads prevailed.
I think, yeah, I would have ended up in Detroit somewhere. But guess what? You still wouldn't have found him.
Back. So, but again, time passing, and I was like, yo, well, let's just chop it up. And then, you know, Mariah, I feel like Mariah won the battle because she put that shit out. She put the Obsessed song out, put Gucci Man on there. Gucci was going at him. Like, it
damn.
Was, and like, I was like, that was well played. You know, I think they both got some records out of it.
Damn.
And everybody went their separate ways. My thing, I was like, yo.
Then the warning dropped. What are you talking about? Like, you're just gonna act like that didn't happen? Gucci Mane, and yes, Mariah put that out, and it was beautiful. She did great. And then M heard that and said, oh, that's supposed to be me? That's supposed to be me, okay. He went and got vocals of hers from messages that she had left. Put those, what is it, mixed it, and put them on a song called The Warning, and then we didn't hear from Nick and Mariah. Yeah. I was like, you don't think that I don't have a lot of this stuff saved? Okay, sure. Wow. Wow.
Oh. Let's come on, wildin' out, man. Let's have some fun with it now. Like at this
you
point,
you talking about with Eminem?
Yeah, that shit.
Shit, man.
Like he one of the best rappers and battle rappers to ever do it.
Yeah.
And he had some fun.
Yeah, absolutely. I don't think.
I don't want to fight no more.
I don't think any of you guys want the kind of smoke this man would come.
It would be amazing,
out.
Though. It would be fucking amazing.
That
it'd
shit
be the best
be
episode.
Biblical. Do you hear me?
Biblical.
Body everybody.
Jeez.
But and again, like I said, he's still in my top five.
Absolutely, man.
But I'm just like. I feel like anytime somebody says something, you a man of strong character and morals.
Absolutely.
Like, you just got to be held accountable.
I got to see you.
Yeah, if you say something.
Absolutely got to see you.
We going to have this conversation.
Yeah.
Like men. That's all I wanted.
Yeah.
And, you know, he was talking and running and he apologized. He did apologize. So.
Well, I mean, I don't even think he did. And then, like, because you got to think about M's career.
Right.
His career, like.
Nobody's held him accountable.
But
nobody's
whooped
his ass.
Nobody's taking him. Nobody's taking him seriously. Like, as far as, like, say, like, you talk about the Backstreet Boys. He's talking
because they ain't trying to whoop his ass.
But.
Have you noticed he never talked out of pocket to none of us?
But
yes,
Benzino.
Ja Rule.
Yeah. That's Benzino.
Cannabis.
But see, like, I think that was calculated.
I don't know.
Because he kind of went at it was more, yeah, all right, I'll give him that.
I mean, I don't know. I'll give you that. I don't think that he went out of his way to go at you necessarily or ever went out of his way to not go at anyone.
Yeah, I think, and again, because
you were kind of collateral damage.
Yeah, I was collateral damage.
You know what I mean? Because
he was talking about, and whatever their personal situation was, the hearsay, and everybody got three sides to the story.
Point is, he wasn't on the jet.
Right.
You dig what I'm saying?
Right. And like I said, whatever y'all had, I don't know. I'm saying, but you're not going to disrespect my wife.
Absolutely.
And that's what it came down to.
I don't care
to.
What y'all had going on. I'm in here cracking lobsters now.
Exactly.
You understand me?
God damn it.
Coast to coast. You understand me?
That was hysterical. Okay, you guys, you saw it for yourself. That is why. That is why. And then that's why we got that verse. I'm kicking my caboose. Bye. I gotta go to sleep, guys. I'm super, super tired.